All right, round three of this daily event, and I'm on the play, and I kept this. Another opening hand elixir. And after playing with elixir for a little bit, I'm unsure about it. It's a win condition that doesn't actually win the game, it just provides inevitability. So, you never actually want to draw it, obviously. If it were an Aetherling, I would... I mean, it would be a little bit better, only in a way that, well, it can actually kill them fast, and it can actually affect the board. Elixir, though, does have one upside, and that would be, it really can't be Thoughtseized. So, if they took your Aetherling, you pretty much lose, but Elixir, you're still good against Mono Black when you have Elixir. And that is a big thing, actually, about it. So I think I'll continue playing Elixir. Green-white. What a deck. Yeah, let's just Jace plus one here. And... he's probably going to have a Selesnya Charm. Don't know if there's anything else he could have that'll matter. Yeah, I don't think so. So Voice is good against me, though. Quicken Supreme Verdict. Okay. That's pretty good, right? Yeah, that's... the problem here... I want a minus two so I can hit a land and do this. If I miss, I have to verdict now and Jace is probably going to die. If I were to just plus one and then verdict, Jace is probably not going to die. I'm going to be greedy. It's only a little greedy anyway, because even if I lose Jace here, I still have like seven cards in my hand, I think. Actually, the real awkward thing is if I miss on land, then I just don't have any land. Alright, Mutavolt. Yeah, I was really hoping he didn't put Mutavolt by itself. That would be some next level stuff there. Yeah, he actually saw the fourth Supreme Verdict. Put that by itself, which I really don't mind. Ooh, you know what? I don't know if they play Rootborn Defenses. Certainly possible. That would be funny, because then he would have two voice tokens for my verdict, or for my, well, Quicken Verdict, and then he would get another one from the Rootborn Defenses, and then, well, I have Verdict again, so that's what I would do. Oh, the value. Hope it doesn't have Rootborn Defenses. I briefly considered Wrathing there in case he did have it, but then my Jace would probably die. So I'll take the chance. And it's kind of interesting, he must put me on Quicken, right? Because I didn't take the Verdict. And if I didn't have a Verdict, I would definitely take the Verdict. Yay. Full value. Okay. Plus one that. And temple go. Probably another Boonsader here. Alright, he's attacking with a token. He's not even attacking Jace with the token. Okay, he's changed his mind. Yeah, I'm just gonna... Oh, okay, he didn't attack at all. I'm just gonna charm it. God's willing. That's pretty spicy. I actually think my Mutavault might be worth less than the Jace. Oh, and oh! You got me. Got me good. Alright, so they're both gonna die. Yeah, he got me. Alright. Wasn't prepared for both of those. Oops. And Advent of the Worm. This deck has so many instants. Yeah, I don't know. Do I bring in Dispel? Like, Boonsader has Flash, but it's not an instant. There's Charm, God's Willing, probably Rootborn Defenses post board, and then Advent. Yeah, I probably do bring in Dispel. Verdict Jace plus one. Yeah. And I think I could actually conceal the Mutavault in this case. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. Another instant. Jeez. He has used his mana very effectively. And he has another Advent. Okay. I don't think we're in any trouble by any means. Yeah, we're gonna play Mutavault. Plus Jason pass, I think. Or we could actually save Revelation for a turn and play Sphere and Divination. And possibly minus two the Jace. Can we really protect the Jace from the Advent? Because four. Yeah, not really. We could make an attempt, but I think I'm better off just minus twoing here. And then playing some action. Jeez. That'll do. I'll take any two card pile here. So we can quicken the divination, so put that on the side. Do we cast Sphere? We're gonna counter the Advent. Sphere is the only way to keep Jace alive. Yeah, let's do it then. So we're gonna get rid of this, counter the advent, block the knight if he wants to attack with it. And untap with Revelation and Elixir, so the game is over. Just a Boon Seder? Yeah, I'll counter that. Yeah, he might have another Selesnya Charm, but that's still fine. He's played three, actually. I could still have it. Yep. We're gonna go to an Elixir now. Oh, no, I can't. Oh. Alright, Revelation. Oh, I see what he meant. He's talking about the Mute Vault tapping. Whoops, why would I do this now? Well, the activating Elixir was kind of just an afterthought, because it doesn't really matter. But I did have a Revelation in the graveyard and three verdicts, so I just figured, why not? Five lands and a sphere. Alright, Elspeth. Yeah, Elspeth, game over. And we'll go ahead and play Temple. No. Actually, yeah, we'll take it. You got it. We'll go ahead and draw that Syncopate. Plus one. Temple. Sure, we'll take it. Let's see, we can quicken into the charm. We block like that. Actually, I should have probably charmed first. Oh no, if he has God's Willing, I wouldn't be able to block. So I'm just gonna do this. And yeah, actually, I really don't care. I'm just gonna let it happen. I'm gonna, yeah, Elixir, then Divination, see if I can get a verdict. Okay, yeah, I think at this point we're gonna Sphere. So in Advent we will Syncopate, I think. We don't have to, but we still will. I could just charm it, but I would rather... Well, I don't know. I guess technically Syncopate is better than charm here. Well, it's possibly as God's Willing, so... Whatever. Yeah, let's just go ahead and... block like that. I think we'll make tokens one more time. Yeah, then we'll ultimate. It's a good insurance card. We could have probably just ultimated and beat him with Mutavaults, but this feels safer. Okay. Glare can come in, Last Breath can come in. Fiend Slayer, not good. Gets trumped by Sleznia Charm and God's Willing. And Boon Seder, if they bestow it. It is good against the Boon Seder if they don't bestow it. Okay, so I think I want less counter spells, especially if I'm bringing in a spell. I think I want very few counter spells. Between Smiter and Voice and the fact that he has tons of instants, we really don't want that many counter spells. So I think this will do. Faded Retribution could definitely come in also, though. Yeah, let's really cut down on the counter spells, I think. Yeah, I'll try this.